This is NDTV, and you're watching NDTV Profit.
Dr. Subir Gokarn is joining in right now. He's a director of research, Brookings India, and former deputy governor at the Reserve Bank of India. Dr. Gokarn, thanks very much for your time, sir. Good morning. Great to have you with us here on NDTV. Prashant this side.
Thank you.
Sir, I'm sure you've looked at all that has been written, not all, but a lot of what has been written after Dr. Rajan taking over. You've noticed financial markets reacting pretty in a pretty exuberant manner to him coming on, but as somebody who's been there at the RBI and who's seen these things for a while, what's your sense? Is everybody overdoing it a little bit, the enthusiasm, the exuberance?
Well, it's always good to greet a new person with a positive response, and I think that signal from the markets was very welcome. He did obviously make an effort to lay out a very concrete set of objectives and also some instrumentalities, some things that he said he would do immediately, which obviously provided some assurance to markets that this wasn't just intent, there was also a plan of action driving it. And I think all of that is very positive, and I think that's basically what we need from the whole system, which is not just statements of intent, but also action plans, how problems are going to be tackled. Now, from the perspective of the overall macro situation, clearly there is a lot going on, a lot of sources of pressure outside the Reserve Bank's control, and we need to see action on those as well. I'm particularly referring to pressure points on the current account as from the short run perspective. I think the new governor has to be very persuasive in making his case that the problem is not going to be solved only by Reserve Bank actions alone, that, that the whole system needs to be in sync and in alignment to address the problem.
Right. But in that sense, do you think he's got the backing of the government and the finance ministry already on a lot of things that he suggested? So apart from what you were saying, things like bringing down the SLR over a period of time in a calibrated manner. I mean, those kind of things. Is that possible in an environment
well,
like this?
Well, I think this is. I think it's a long overdue measure. I think the SLR is something that has basically survived because it is an instrument that allows the government to borrow at rates lower than it would have to otherwise. And he himself indicated that when the deficit is so large, it's a little difficult to visualize a very dramatic change in this. This has been talked about for quite some time. If you recall, going back 10 years actually, the SLR portfolio was mark-to-market. That is, banks took the price risk on their portfolios. It was only after 2003 that this requirement was taken away, and so effectively banks have had a relatively comfortable portfolio choice where they are required to invest, yes, but they don't have to bear any of the risk. So some adjustment there I think is necessary, and one of the consequences of that is going to be that the government will have to borrow at a higher rate, because banks are not required then, if you change the SLR structure, to own those securities, buy those securities. So it's going to be a transition. It's going to be a process that needs to be managed as fiscal consolidation takes place, which hopefully it will. The pressure on government to borrow such large amounts of money will go down. And that is a phase during which I think we can simultaneously address the issue of the SLR. One very important benefit from eliminating the SLR, or at least bringing it down very substantially, is that it will incentivize banks to trade their government securities portfolio, which as of now they don't have the incentive to do. And that is, I think, a very important requirement to get a debt market going, a domestic debt market going. Now, Dr. Rajan, along with many other people, have been very, very strong advocates of activating and sustaining a domestic debt market. And I think this step, if it is to be executed successfully, will be a very important contribution to that process.
Right. Did you see hints of a broader shift in Dr. Rajan's speech and the operating style of the RBI as far as monetary policy is concerned? So a committee headed by Dr. Urjit Patel is going to suggest revisions and possible changes in the monetary policy framework. What exactly should we sort of gather from this?
I think the Committee on Financial Sector Reforms, which Dr. Rajan headed and which submitted its report in 2008, I think, or maybe 2007, basically suggested that the RBI should now focus on a single target, that is an inflation targeting regime. Other committees that have made recommendations of the financial sector have suggested an explicit target for monetary policy rather than trying to do many things simultaneously. I presume that this this committee, this internal group that's or composite group that has now been set.